Hello everyone. So today we will talk about Thomas Carlyle and his famous work Sartor Resartus. And so yeah, let's get started. But before that, make sure to subscribe and like this video and comment what you want to see next. So Thomas Carlyle, he is a Victorian writer and he is a Calvinist. Calvinists are those who believe that the life which we have, it is all due to God, and humans are born sinners, and it is the kindest gesture of God to make us alive on the earth. So those are Calvinist. He got his education from University of Edinburgh, and as a profession he wanted to join church, but it did not happen. Then he wanted to pursue his career as a mathematician, but finally he becomes a renowned writer. And he has major influence from the German writers, and he used to follow the philosophy of German writers. The very first and foremost famous work before Sartor Resartus is the translation of Goethe's novel Wilhelm Meister's. So this was the very first novel which he translated, and he also did apprenticeship in English, and when he died he was buried in Scotland. So there are two very famous books by him. First is the French Revolution, and the second one is the Sartor Resartus, and today we will talk about Sartor Resartus. So Sartor is a character. In Sartor Resartus there is a character named Diogenes, and he is the character. And one more thing, Sartor Resartus means, it's in Latin and it means tailor retailored. It is divided into three books, of 11, of 10 and of 12, and there are three stages in this book: stage of negation, stage of indifference and stage of affirmation. This is a political satire, and as we have discussed, he uses German philosophy. And he has used the metaphor of clothes. Opens with editor lamenting the current scientific world view. So he satirizes everything. And he satirizes everything about the Victorian era. The editor decides to translate the writing of a German philosopher into English. He also decides to learn about the life of philosopher Diogenes. So that is why Diogenes is the protagonist in this book. And right, so we also get to know that Diogenes' writings are found stuffed in six paper bags which the editor has to go through. The social, political and religious entities which impair the vision of man and fail to show him the spiritual world. So he says that man is far away from the spiritual world. He is more involved into the materialistic world, and that is what Thomas Carlyle never liked, because he was a stern believer of Calvinism. So he wanted people to take interest in religious things, spiritual entities, but because materialism was on the peak at the time of Industrial Revolution, so that is what he is satirizing here. And one more protagonist is there, whose name is Stalford Rock, whose meaning is God-born devil's dung. So this is very ironic and symbolic work. So the book 2, chapter 7 is very important, because it is the center of indifference there, and it is also shown the second birth of Stalford Rock, his spiritual birth. That means in your life, when you have that spiritual enigma and spiritual renaissance in yourself, so that is your second birth. Through this book he converted doubt to faith, because 19th century is all about doubt, and faith was not there, because scientific era, it was known as a scientific era where everything is doubted. He also says that nature is living garment of God. Body is a garment which clothes the soul. Different clothes symbolize the different professions. Clothes create barrier between appearance and reality. Soul is truth and body illusion. So Sartre Resartes is nothing, but it is a critique on the 19th century, the Victorian era, where people have no faith in God, no humanity, and everything was about facts, as we see in the Charles Dickens novel Hard Times. Everything is about reason, about fact. Nothing is about humanity or emotions. So the emotionless society, he wanted to make the society full of emotions, not emotionless. I also quote a line from the text: a man willing to work and unable to find work is perhaps the saddest sight that fortune's inequality exhibits under the sun, unquote. A loving heart is the beginning of all knowledge. So that is the thing, that you should have love in your heart for others. Never be so selfish and self-proclaimed and self-obsessed. So the basic idea of this text is that have faith in God, indulge yourself in spiritual activities, and also have love for others. So that is about it. I just summed up the basic gist of Sartre Resartes. It was not in detail. Let me know if you want to see anything in detail. I will love to do that. So I'll take your leave now. Hope this was helpful for you guys.